why not? And why not tweet when something tweet-worthy happens?
That is the point of Twitter, after all.
Yeah. And I'll even use a hashtag, awesome hardware. I spelled it correctly, too. All right. So I've just tweeted, which means I can begin the show. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Awesome Hardware. This is a show. We do it live. This is my buddy Kyle. We stream to each of our YouTube channels. Right now you're watching my half of the show, which is on my channel, Paul's Hardware. First half of today's episode, which is number 81, by the way, is on Kyle's channel, which is Bitwit. So check that out. It should be linked in the description down below. And we've had a good time so far. Usually we talk about technology, other random things. We enjoy a beverage with responsible. We drink responsibly is what I was trying to say. We encourage a slight amount of responsible drinking. And we also, I guess that's everything. I think that's pretty much all.
Buy our shirts.
Yeah, so
Buy our stuff.
If you're joining us, thanks for being here. In case you're wondering, we have already killed this guy right here, which was a Lost Abbey Gift of the Magi Ale.
Not to be mistaken for the Downtown Abbey, which I confused it with earlier.
Different from Downton Abbey.
I feel dumb.
Although that is a 12%er. Kyle and I split that one. Now we're sharing this Anderson Valley Oatmeal Stout. The Barney Flats Oatmeal Stout, which is also a nice, solid stout. So, yeah. Cheers to all you guys who happen to be here with us, and welcome. And let's kick things off by encouraging any of you guys who enjoy any of our content to check out our stores. You can buy some stuff and help support us. bitwit.tech/store is Kyle's store.
Buy a BioSlasher shirt.
BioSlasher shirts are available.
Look at how funny it is.
They're very
flashing
funny.
The BIOS.
He's flashing the BIOS.
Come on. All your nerdy friends will be like,
right there,
dude, you are the man.
Clearly.
That is the best shirt I've ever seen.
Clearly, that is
a humorous
shirt.
I just saw a couple people at TwitchCon wearing that shirt. Obviously. Yep.
If you want to buy from my store, it's paulshardware.net or store.paulshardware.net. And I have also a variety of shirts. I've got some hoodies and some polos and also mugs and pint glasses, which we're drinking out of today, as well as some new tri-blend shirts, which are super soft and sexy and all that good stuff. Shout out to anyone who's joining us in chat. Also, big shout out to, I believe we had Spider here earlier, as well as Cell.
Yep.
Thanks for helping us out, guys, with
EG
some
mods.
Moderation, all that good stuff. Yeah. Let's continue the show as we usually do the second half.
No! Garrett, thank you very much for your $5 donation.
Thank you, Garrett.
Kyle, when are we getting those 6X Stay Positive shirts? I bought 2 shirts last week. Come on, man.
Come on, man. Where's the 6X's?
Sorry, do you have 6X's?
I usually get some 6X's stocked, yeah.
I usually have like 2, maybe 3 6X's or at a time.
It's usually,
they get sold out.
It's usually just a couple at a time is why, because they don't move quite as quickly as the shirt sizes that are a little bit more common. So
you just have to keep a close eye on the store.
They are there, though.
Yeah.
We try to
accommodate everyone.
All right. We good?
Yep.
Is that all?
Yep.
Okay. So news. We're starting off with this little bit of news here. I don't have a lot of... Oh, you know what I should do is get rid of that. I don't have a lot of interesting news for my half of the show.
Sweet.
Most of it's kind of random.
Love it.
So Sorry, that was my bad. Eurogamer.net has posted this article about the Call of Duty Infinite Warfare and Modern Warfare Remastered on PC. Taking up 130 gigs of freaking space on your hard drive.
Jesus.
Which is absolutely insane. It's listed right here on the back of the box.
For PlayStation? For PlayStation
4? No,
this
is the PC version.
Oh, the PC version.
This is for... PlayStations don't have 130 gigs of space.
I know.
This is the PlayStation 4.
I know, that's why. It looks like the PlayStation 4 cartridge.
How much space is there on a PlayStation 4?
You might be able to have 500 to a gig.
500
for a terabyte?
Gigs? Something like that.
Maybe a terabyte.
Anyway, all right. Well, that's insane. I thought it was a PC version because I was like, no, that's insane for them to include on a console.
The graphics can't be that good. How many textures can they actually put in?
I do not know, but
look at that.
I don't know. Are any of you Are you excited about Call of Duty?
No, I've never been. Well, I was a Call of Duty guy back when Modern Warfare 2 was out.
Okay.
I was in college. I think it was like sophomore, junior year maybe. And then I never, maybe senior year. But I have not played Call of Duty regularly since then. I've been playing Battlefield here and there, but
yeah.
I
was never into it that much. I did some COD Blops back in the day.
Yeah.
I mainly played it so I could say COD Blops.
COD Blops. Black Ops.
But yeah, keep an eye out for that one if you have a PlayStation 4, and especially if you are low on the space, I suppose. Big shout out and a thank you to MB67. Thank you for your $20 donation. Woo! Oh my God. He says, I love the show and please help. I'm being held prisoner in a server closet somewhere in Southern California.
You have to donate more than that.
I don't know.
You have to donate more than $20 to bail yeah.
We need more to go on than that, I think, would be the main.
More information, the more main money. Issue.
I think the camera got bumped a little bit.
You want to bump it back?
I feel like we're off center. Slow, Kyle.
Stop it, Nori.
That's better. Okay, cool. Yay.
Hero, excuse me.
Now Hero's in the way.
Am I supposed to ride you to my seat?
That's one way.
Nori. Calm down.
I have dogs.
Calm down, Nori.
Oh my goodness.
Good Lord. Okay, you can see your hero.
Hero's going to be
there.
You're
good.
She's going to be there for us to pet for the rest
of the
show.
He's a big, gentle giant.
That's part of what happens.
He's key.
Nori.
You're not noisy at all.
Shut up.
You're so quiet.
Shut your mouth for you.
Shut your quiet
That's
dog.
How that works. Okay, let's continue my news stories, which are all fascinating.
Okay.
Star Citizen.
Yeah.
When did the excitement about that die out? If you wanted another reason to be not excited about Star Citizen, their single-player campaign has been delayed indefinitely.
What?
Yes.
Indefinitely.
Not indefinitely is perhaps a little bit of an exaggerated term, but basically they were supposed to have a launch in 2016, but that is not going to happen now. The single-player campaign Squadron 42 will be delayed indefinitely. The reason is, with so much left undone, there's huge chunks of the single-player campaign yet unfinished. CIG had originally promised Squadron 42 would ship in 2016. Not going to happen now. And they have yet to announce a new shipping date, so that's not promising either. Obviously, there are different sides you could take in this particular argument. You could say, screw them, Cloud Imperium Games, you lied to us. You had all of this talk about your fabulous game, and you haven't launched it, and it's stupid, and I'm mad. Or you could say, Cloud Imperium Games, you've been developing a AAA title for about 4 years now, and most AAA titles take at least that long, if not longer, to come out. So maybe there's a slight bit of leniency there. I don't know. I honestly haven't read up enough on this particular ongoing situation with Star Citizen to give a more nuanced response than that. Are you having a problem with the dogs?
He's laying down like.
Oh yeah, Hero.
Directly.
Hero's just right there.
But that's okay. I can just.
Let's go. You know, go over your bed. Go to your
Look
bed.
There's a comfy bed.
Here, go to your bed.
So much softer than the floor.
Go to your bed.
Good boy.
Good boy.
Good boy.
He's a good boy.
I just tweeted a picture of him.
Here, go to your bed.
Keep going.
No, he's worried. Okay. Okay, good. Now he's.
Swear to God, Nori.
Now he wants more attention.
I swear to God.
Now he wants more attention.
I will destroy
you. I would show people him more, but he doesn't like to, like, hop up. When you ask him to. Anyway, yeah, so that's the situation over at Cloud Imperium Games and Star Citizen. Right now their plan is to bring one their plan is to bring one chapter of the campaign to a final polish, then showcase that chapter as both an illustration that something is being done on the title, and to demonstrate the art and style choices that have been shown in some screenshots and videos.
Okay.
So, yeah, they're still working on stuff.
It's like the longest game development period ever.
Yeah.
Like, holy crap. It's never going to be able to live up to
all
the hype.
Like, I'm kind of...
Never.
Well, maybe the only way it can live up to all that hype is by taking so long that the hype dies off completely.
So no one expects anything anymore?
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, that could be it.
So
maybe that's their whole game.
That could be the plan. I mean, they made so much money with their original launch and everything that maybe they don't care. Maybe they're just like, whatever, we're going to take as long as we freaking want to
because
make this
game. We're all millionaires.
And you're all going to be happy when it launches with whatever the hell we launch with.
It could be it. But I would like to see this game release at some point in my lifetime.
I would too.
I think we'll probably make it to actual Mars first. Like, Elon Musk will probably land on Mars before...
Yeah,
Imperium
we'll have
Games.
Star Citizen Mars, and that maybe that's their goal as well. They're going to coordinate the launch with the Mars launch to sort of create a frenzy around space exploration.
Makes sense.
That's what I'm looking forward to. Yeah. All right.
Love it.
I thought I saw another. No, that was the same one. Okay, let's move on to the next story, which is about silkworms, which. Obviously, is something we talk about on the show all the time. Freaking silkworms, right?
Yeah.
Shut up about silkworms. But these silkworms have been basically infused with carbon nanotubes.
I'm gonna say like infused with tequila.
Infused with
usually
tequila.
Tequila drinkers like to put worms in their drinks.
I could see how that might have been confusing, but these have been infused with carbon nanotubes
so that they
spin graphene nanotube super silk. Which I imagine is like what Spider-Man uses to swing around, right? Yeah, he's got to be able to.
You should ask Spider-Fan.
To flick out something like that. These are silkworms.
Yeah, they are.
They're eating.
I used to have some.
They're eating mulberry leaves.
Mulberry.
Mulberries actually do have berries. I didn't think that. We had a mulberry tree outside of my house when I was growing up. Never had berries on it. And then Steve just like. Basically blew my mind this weekend by saying these are mulberries, and I was like, what are you talking about? They look kind of like boysenberries or blueberries or something like that.
Weird.
Anyway, as you can see, there's lots of words in this article here on Scientific American.
Worms like berries.
I have a couple notes here. So like, here's the problem. We've been hearing about carbon nanotubes for quite a while because they have fantastic properties. They have, you know, they can like conduct electricity at really low resistance and that kind of thing, but we haven't seen them used for just about anything because the manufacturing process is very, very difficult. So what they're doing here with these silkworms is basically having the silkworms create the material by infusing them with carbon nanotubes.
Nanotubes.
They feed them the graphene. I don't know how they feed them that. I don't know how you infuse something that you eat with graphene. But I kind of want to do that for myself. Then I would have graphene-infused poop.
What is the benefit of graphene?
I don't know. Maybe that would be a bad idea. Maybe it would be challenging if, like, there was ever a clog in the toilet or whatever. It'd be very, you know, it'd be far too durable to actually clear. Maybe that's a bad idea. I shouldn't go with that.
Or maybe it breaks down your poop, and
people don't do that.
It's great for constipation.
What they're talking about here, though, is things like wearable electronics and medical implants. You need something that is conductive but also flexible and strong. So a very thin strand of carbon nanotube-infused silk seems like a pretty viable way to do that. Durable protective fabrics, biodegradable medical implants, and eco-friendly wearable electronics are all potential outcomes of this. They fed the worms mulberry leaves sprayed with aqueous solutions containing 0.2% by weight of either carbon nanotubes or graphene, and then collected the silk after the worms spun their cocoons, as is done with standard silk production. You have to kill the poor moth inside, by the way, just in case you're wondering. Yes, mass genocide of silkworms. It's all right. That's how you get silk clothes. Treating already spun silk would require dissolving the nanomaterials in toxic chemical solvents and applying those to the silk. So feeding them the feeding method is much simpler and much more environmentally friendly. In contrast to regular silk, the carbon-enhanced silks are twice as tough and can withstand at least 50% higher stress before breaking. They heated silk fibers to 1,050 degrees Celsius to carbonize the silk protein and then studied their conductivity and structure. Modified silks conduct electricity, unlike regular silk, and spectroscopy.
Yeah,
electron microscopy imaging showed the carbon-enhanced silk fibers had more ordered crystal structure due to the incorporated nanomaterials. I think that's kind of badass. Anyway, so I want a silk tunic with the computer in it that is like a
Kevlar.
Yeah, it's got to stop bullets.
Yep.
It needs to have the like. It's got to be like the Harry Potter's, you know, cloak of invisibility as well. Just make you invisible whenever.
Why not?
Right. That'd be cool.
Yeah.
And it needs to be reasonably priced.
And
have like a cool app.
And environmentally friendly.
And environmental. Yes.
Go green.
That's my prediction.
By the way, thank you very much, Shantanu Josh, for the $20.
Shantanu Joshi.
Thank you for tweeting me. I will go ahead and check that later on tonight or tomorrow. Love you guys. Don't ever stop this show. We probably will not, unless one of us dies. Well, if one of us died, probably just hire someone else on, right?
What?
I mean, we're all replaceable.
Everyone's replaceable.
Everyone's replaceable. Or if, like, we moved far away from each other, then we would probably stream in, but that wouldn't be as fun. So I'd probably just quit and be like, fuck off.
These... Such a bright future we have to look forward to.
Yeah, that's life.
Yeah. But I don't think we have any immediate plans to stop the show.
I don't think so.
I'm cool with it.
Thank you for your donation,
Thank
Mr. Josh.
You. Much obliged for the donation. All right. What's next? What is next on my magical list of... No, we have a little bit of news about Newegg.
Oh, yes.
So, full disclosure here before we get into this, and I have no idea if... We probably don't even need to say this, but we both used to work for Newegg.
We did?
I just want to throw that out there. We both did, yeah.
No.
So this is a bit of news, actually a little bit over a week old. So there it is. But this is actually a Chinese article. It has been translated by Google Translate, so that's why the translation might not be all that great if you're just trying to read it straight up. But basically, Newegg is no longer owned by the former owner of Newegg, whose name was Fred Chang. It is now owned a majority stake in the company, 55.7%. To be specific, is now owned by Lou Enterprises.
Lou? The guy from Unbox Therapy?
It is, no, L-U. It is
his Asian brother.
That's what we can assume.
Oh.
That is a mainland Chinese company.
Okay.
They spent 8.8 billion yuan in order to buy this majority stake. Newegg was attempting to go public in the U.S. They had an IPO going for a little while, but it never actually panned out. So much the worse for my stock options that I had briefly. That's cool, though. But yeah.
Okay, so that's 1.3 billion U.S.
1.3 billion U.S. is what that is?
You said 8.8 Chinese yuan, right?
8.8 billion NT.
Oh. NT?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know if NT is different from a yuan.
NT. Yeah, it is.
8.1. Oh, yeah. This is listing NT. Maybe this is a Taiwanese article or something like that.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's $250 million.
Yeah, $278
million. 250 to 280 million dollars.
Yeah.
For a 55.7% stake, it values the overall price of the company at about $500 million, which seems less than what it was perhaps years ago.
Yeah.
But basically the controlling controlling share of the company is now owned by this company, Lou Enterprises. We don't really know much about them.
Does Fred Chang have any kind of power anymore?
I mean, I would imagine he would still remain on the board or something like that. I don't know. But
yeah.
There's another article here about them receiving an investment from Hangzhou Liaison Interactive Informative Technology Incorporated, another story. I actually have a couple stories about this linked in the description. Unfortunately, they are behind paywalls, which was weird because when I first looked at them, they weren't. So sorry about that. But... the follow-up story to that was that Li Cheng, who we've talked about here on the show before, mainly when we've talked about patent disputes and that kind of thing, because Newegg has a bit of a history of going after patent trolls, that we have often, I believe, hailed as a pretty positive thing.
Mm-hmm.
Here, for example, is Li Cheng saying, "Patents are bullshit." Yeah, so there's
he's the patent troll king.
Yeah, There's Lee right there. So he has apparently left Newegg within the past couple weeks. That's Lee in the middle there.
He's working for,
He has gone to be the COO, I believe, or at least a C-level position at Gibson Guitars.
That's right, yeah.
Which is kind of, I kind of want to change. I like Gibson Guitars.
Yeah, maybe hit him up for a review sample.
Yeah, I mean, we got a ukulele back there.
Ukulele.
Gibson might make ukulele.
Just send that time code if you playing the ukulele.
Ukulele.
Like,
look.
Yeah. Send me a guitar, Lee. But yeah, so we have no idea or speculation on what this might mean for Newegg as a company. My assumption would be that Newegg US, which is, you know, it's own little bubble of what it works in Newegg US. I mean, obviously it's owned by a Chinese company. We don't know what changes this might mean for the company as a whole. I would assume not much on the face of it, right out of the gate. But also typically when something like this happens, at this point in a year, like it is Q4 now, leading up to Black Friday and the holiday season. Usually if something like this happens, everything's going to be status quo through the holiday season. They want everyone to kind of keep doing their jobs and making the money and all that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So if there were going to be changes or anything different, that would probably be more like next year sometime that we'd see something like that happen.
Right.
Again, that's all speculation, and Hero just bumps the camera. Nori is barking. Barking ever so softly. Hero's kind of... What is that noise Hero's making?
It's like a squeak toy.
It is kind of like a squeaky toy.
That's
yeah.
Hero? The squeakiness?
Yeah, Nori is the one making the, like, bark, bark noise. Hero's a big baby. He is a big baby.
He's like baby Huey.
Yeah. Hold on. Wife... Well, she might be home. She said she stopped at the mall.
Out okay. Shopping. Women be shopping.
Doggies. Women be shopping. All right. What's next? Oh, it's mail time.
Yay, mail time.
I don't have a mail time lower thirds here for some reason, so okay. I'm using this one instead. Mail time.
Bork, bork.
Weird.
My gosh.
Weird
Hero
freaking
sounds
noise.
Possessed or something.
Oh, that Hero's making. Wow. Okay.
Oh, can I open this one?
Certainly you can. I have blocked off...
I wonder if there's money in it.
...pertinent information.
Oh, yeah.
So, guys, if you want to send us some stuff, P.O. Box 4325, Diamond Bar, California, area code 91765 is where you want to send that to. Paul's Hardware.
Sweet.
P.O. Box 4325, Diamond Bar, California. I don't list that many places. I only say it in certain videos and stuff like that. So, people have sent us this stuff. We're going with the completely, I have no idea what's in any of these boxes route. Kyle has opened the first letter, which is from...
Francisco.
Francisco from... I made it so we could say where they're from. From California.
California.
Francisco A. from California.
Nice.
Sent us a nice letter.
This is a 2-page thing. I probably should not read the whole thing right now.
That is, all right. So you glance at that and get an idea.
Okay.
We have junior officer stickers here from El Centro, California, from the El Centro Police Department. My assumption is that we can wear these... and basically break any laws that we want to, and that we will be immune from any repercussions from local law enforcement. So I appreciate that. That, or perhaps these can be traded like tokens or coupons. Like if you're pulled over or something like that, you'd be like,
"Yeah, I've got
here
one.
You go, officer. You this is like my get out of jail free card." And then they just take it like, "All right, that's for this one, but next time we're gonna get you." But yeah, I like El Centro Police Department junior officer badges. That's pretty badass. Can we get a brief summary of the?
Oh, yes, he's been watching us since like the Newegg days.
Holy crap!
We taught him, or I guess you taught him initially how to build a computer with your how to build a PC video series at Newegg. He said he watched it over and over.
Nice.
He even watched the updated version that you and I did back at Newegg.
Oh, that one was. Bit more snarky.
Yes, it was. Had a bit more spark to it, I guess.
Sell, hold on. That's the wrong... 4325.
God damn it, sell!
4325.
What?
P.O. Box 4325. Cell posted the P.O. Box in chat, but it wasn't the right.
Oh.
Wow, Nori, calm down.
Good lord. Good lord, Doggy.
I do not know why she's freaking out so
also, he
badly.
Says that he's the go-to IT guy for the El Centro Police Department.
Shh, Nori. Oh, well, that's good.
Yeah, that's cool. So he does some IT stuff for them. He works there. He built this first computer because of us. He watches our channel almost every day to see if there's anything new.
Whoa.
I know we don't post every day like mine. Sorry about that.
I need to come up with more frequent videos then.
I'm
going to punch Nori in the face. Hold on. Here, I'll come
here. Come here.
You've been part of me that's helping me. And several stickers. Well, thank you very much, Francisco. We really do appreciate that. And we're super honored that you watch our show.
I am too.
Our shameless.
Wonderful. All right. Next up is a package here. This is from Zach F., and this comes from Ohio. And I hope there's nothing dangerous in this box, because we were kind of on the fence at the beginning of the show, whether... Oh,
I'm wearing a sticker that Francisco gave us.
Nice.
He gave us a lot of these junior officer State of California Police Department stickers.
I'm going to wear those.
Which means that I can now get pulled over and not go get arrested for anything. I'm going to shoot a cop.
Nori is very mad right now.
She is. Holy shit.
Okay.
She needs to take a chill pill.
This, once again, is from Zach... from Ohio.
Ohio.
This is from the Tech Syndicate Lounge. And Soul Fallen. Alright.
What?
Dear,
they have a lounge?
We need Nori to shut her mouth. My wife is home at last. That's good.
Should we close the door or we're good?
Yeah, you can close the door. That'd probably be okay. Okay. We're gonna close the door, guys, now that my wife is home. To try to...
Hi, Diana. Oh, no.
Hero. Hero's okay. Let Hero out. Keep Nori on the other side. All right. Hero will not bark. Good boy, Hero.
Hero, calm down.
Oh, he's excited. Okay. Continuing to read this note.
Okay.
Ah, it's so nice when Nori's not barking. Dear Paul, it is with great honor that the Tech Syndicate Lounge bestows upon you the China Cabinet Awareness Award for your brave comments on July 28th, 2016, raising awareness to all watchers of your waifu doesn't love you, that all of us have China cabinets, and it's nothing to be ashamed of. Best wishes to you. Sincerely, Soul Fallen and the Tech Syndicate Lounge. All right.
Do you know what that means?
No.
Okay. just check it.
I have a vague idea. All right, there we go.
So this is a guy who's in the Tech Syndicate community?
Yeah, Soul Fallen is it's part of the Tech Syndicate community. Oh, it's a China cabinet.
It actually is a China cabinet.
This is a... It's wooden? Here, can you explore that? Now I'll see if there's...
I'll see if there's any, opium in here. That's what Chinese people put in these things, right?
Yes, opium. That's what we're hoping for.
There's no opium.
What?
Or opium mat.
That is a really...
But it is a pretty cool...
That
little,
is a really cool little tiny China cabinet.
What are you going to put in here? Just like, I don't know. Like, extra...
I feel like I need really small little plates or something like that.
Yeah, you do need some tiny plates now. If you could send Paul some little plates to put in his little Chinese cabinet.
A centimeter across or something like that.
Great.
All right. Thank you, Soul Fallen. Thank you to participants of the Tech Syndicate Lounge.
Very detailed.
Stay strong, you guys. Chris Warren, thank you for your $5 donation. Oh, it just went away. Where'd it go?
Because double fuck the GTX 960.
Chris Warren, thank you. I'm about to buy a new monitor. What do you recommend? The 2560 by 1080, 144 hertz? Or 3440 by 1440, 75 hertz? Ooh, that's a tough call.
What do you have for my video card?
Yeah, my question would be, do either of those support G-Sync or FreeSync and a compatible video card from your side of it? 3440 by 1440 at 75 hertz, I think is just fine if you have FreeSync or G-Sync. I think that would be a FreeSync display because I think the G-Sync variants at that rate are 100 hertz. But yeah, I mean, also consider what types of games you play. If you play really twitchy type games, if you're really into like CSGO, FPS games
that
require
the higher refresh rate.
Then in that case, yeah, go for the higher refresh rate. But I would probably lean towards the 3440 by 1440 just because
it's prettier.
It's super pretty. It's a very nice resolution to game.
Pretty. And also a Jominator for the $5 donation because double fuck the GTX 960.
Double fuck it right in the cornhole. Right. Next. This one is from Alexander M. from Georgia.
He invented the radio.
Georgia on my mind.
Georgia.
That's Martha.
Oh.
Is that what you're trying to say?
No, I wasn't. I'm saying Georgia many times.
Cool.
In a row.
I have no idea what's in here, but it is very well packed.
You ever wonder if it's just going to explode?
I hope it doesn't. Also, my... This knife is usually...
No, it's not a dildo.
This knife is usually... All right, I got it. Okay.
Oh,
so this is from Alex. He put his Twitter handle here, FlareStormRev. I'm a longtime follower of both of your channels. I actually followed you guys from when you did videos for Newegg. Thank you, Alex. I enjoy watching your videos. He likes awesome hardware. Sweet. I wanted to share some special treats from my local grocery store's bakery.
Ooh.
Hopefully you and your wives enjoy. If it melted in transportation, you just need to freeze it and break it back into pieces. I love stuff like that. Hopefully these reach you intact, as it's a pretty decent temperature outside. And if we're ever in Georgia, we're going to hit you up, Alex, and we're going to go to Micro Center and Fry's.
That'd be sick.
For sure. Absolutely. Yeah. All right.
Wait, so it's from a store?
It's from a store.
Oh, it looks pretty sealed. Oh, my good Lord.
Oh.
Oh.
There you go.
Oh. Sea salt pretzel cocoa bar. What? But, I mean, he could have, like, opened these and, like, tampered with them and
no,
tried to kill
no,
us, right?
No, that's impossible.
No, you're right. We should definitely try it.
This
right
is
now.
Birthday cake flavored bark.
Oh, my God. All right, let me try some of that, and you can try some of this. This is sea salt pretzel cocoa bark.
Okay.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, God, bark.
Sorry, the reflection.
Wow, I should not have even glanced at the nutritional information on this thing.
Oh, really? There's nutrition? Oh
no, don't look
God.
At it. You
oh,
really
my
should,
God.
Really should
oh,
not.
God.
Don't even.
I'm scarred for life.
No, just pretend it goes away immediately.
Where's your sharp knife?
Need the sharp knife for this stuff? All right.
Cut that shit open.
Kyle's gonna...
I gotta test it for science. Make sure it's, you know...
Kyle's gonna open these up.
Up to code.
In the meantime, that is all for
FDA approved.
For what was supposed to be mail time.
I'm trying the birthday cake
and
first.
We're going to transition very quickly into our sponsor spot.
Oh God.
Yes, indeed.
Oh God.
How good is it?
Don't eat it.
Don't eat it.
Don't do it.
Maybe just a small piece. Well, it's like.
It's like white chocolate, birthday cake flavored.
It's just never. This shouldn't exist. It's not fair.
Oh my God.
It's not fair to people who aren't eating this right
mm-hmm.
now.
Mm.
Is this a pretzel thing?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, what? How's that
don't
even.
Just don't speak. Don't talk.
Oh.
Alright.
I'll put it away.
Putting it away fast.
In a way.
My goodness.
Alright. I think it's fun.
We're gonna get really high in like an hour.
Yeah, exactly. That's usually how long it takes for it to kick in. Okay. Kyle?
Yep.
The 1100, if you please.
Yes.
A huge thank you to Fractal Design for sponsoring our show. Excuse me. It's just the...
It'll kill you.
The orgasms in my throat are...
Stuff will kill you.
They're hard to get down there. All right. So for today's sponsor spot from Fractal Design, link down in the description if you want to check out the Fractal Design website. We have this case. Fractal makes primarily cases. They also do some power supplies and coolers and stuff. Also, a nice array of fans. This is a budget case from Fractal. The Core 1100, which only costs about $40 US. I have built a system in here. The entire system is about in the $700 to $750 price range, depending on some of the parts and where you're at and how much shipping and stuff costs. But we have a 6500 in here, We have a GTX 1060, a 240 gig hard drive, as well as a 2 terabyte SSD, power supply up there at the top, and a fan that was included, and then I added another fan onto the side panel here for an intake. So basically you have a very powerful system and a very small footprint with all of the basic features that you would need from a case for only about $40. So if you're on a budget and you need to get yourself up and off the ground with a solid case.
It's a good budget case.
Yeah, budget case, but painted interior. Plenty of space there for a basic set of drives and whatnot. And a nice included 120 millimeter fan that stays pretty quiet too, which is
the front, I
which
believe.
Is cool.
Yep.
Yeah.
Looks like it.
Single 120 millimeter fan at the front, and that's one of the things that is often pretty crappy on budget cases is the fan that's included. This one up here, it stays pretty quiet. In
nice.
Fact, the one that I added on the side is noticeably louder than that front one. So
practical case fans are always pretty quiet.
We'll see how that goes.
Even on their budget series stuff.
Yep.
And so, I like how it's like it's got a really clean front panel.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, has USB 3.0.
A USB 3 and a USB 2 on there?
Yep. But it's also got some ventilation on the sides of it, so you do get some fresh intake there. It's not completely closed off.
Yes,
so
indeed.
That's nice.
It's a micro ATX case, but I think a very viable option for anyone who's building a small budget system or a new builder. There's not a ton of cable management room, but there's some space up here in the front where you can kind of tuck cables away and that kind of thing. And check out the Fractal website if you guys want some more information on that.
Do it.
These are available on like Amazon, Newegg, pretty much any online retailer where you would find fine computer parts and that type of thing.
We put links in the description of our YouTube videos.
Yes, indeed.
Yes.
All right.
Yes, we have.
And thanks again, Fractal, for sponsoring our show.
Oh, yeah.
We're now moving on to the final like quarter of Awesome Hardware, which is usually...
Yep. The best quarter.
Usually the best part, but I don't know what's next.
Sword fight.
Sword fight's next. Oh, yeah. I have stuff planned. All right, time for sword fight, which means Kyle and I are going to be arguing about something with
what?
Sword fight. But before we do, a big thank you to Zach Vasquez. Thank you so much for your $5 donation over on the YouTubes. He says, thanks, love the show. I just finished building my PC with a 6950X, 128 gigs of RAM, two Titan XPs, and SLI. What do I do next?
Game on it.
Just a scenario. I'm not stupid rich. LOL. Nothing, Zach. You can do nothing. The only thing you could do beyond that is look at Xeons or like server configurations or like next gen hardware, that kind of thing. Super fast storage arrays.
Give it to me.
Don't get me wrong. There's always somewhere you can go with a build. But when you got a 6950X and two Titan XPs.
Custom water cooler if you haven't already.
Yeah, you could delve into water cooling.
Yeah.
That'd be somewhere to go.
Yeah.
Get yourself, you know, a slight boost in performance, but a lot of fun just kind of figuring it out
it's
and all that
experience.
Kind of stuff, and something else to spend money on.
Mm-hmm.
That is for damn sure.
You've clearly run out of things to buy.
All right, so let's talk about this. What is this?
So your first sword fight question, Paul, that we're debating today, is
yes,
what should I do with my Galaxy Note 7, which if you guys were watching my half of the show,
yeah.
is completely dead now. Samsung announced on Tuesday, which I believe is today, that they will be discontinuing the Galaxy Note 7, which hardly even launched. Which means, what about people who already own a Galaxy Note 7 that hasn't exploded yet? Do they get to keep their phones? Or are they forced to give them back? I wasn't sure on that. But it seems like they can keep them.
What is this?
But Samsung will not be selling. They've urged all of their redistributors to stop selling Galaxy Note 7.
Smoking Samsung phone caught on video. Oh, look. Wow.
Holy
She just walked out holding this phone that's just...
How is she not burning?
I don't know. She should be consumed by the flames of damnation right now. That's in my experience, that's how the Samsung Galaxy... Alright, so...
Why do these people have a creepy webcam in the corner of their house? That's weird.
Yeah, so Samsung, they're not saying, like, we're redoing replacements or anything like that. They're saying... We're cutting off this device completely. We're killing it.
Yep.
It is no longer going to be there. So this article on Tampa Bay Times asks the question, now that they've killed it, what do I do now? Asks some important questions such as, I have one of the replacement phones. Do I need to stop using it? Answer is yes. How bad have the fires been? Answer is they can be bad if the phone is in the wrong place. Did I just waste nearly $1,000 in the Note 7? There are still some questions in the loop about how things are going to go about for the refund, but one has to assume that they will be refunding people who bought it, you know, either through the ISP or the cell phone provider, service provider.
Or directly from
Samsung. Or directly, if they bought it directly, or possibly through a retailer. If you exchange a Note 7 for another Samsung product, you get an extra $25 in the form of a gift card, in-store credit, or bill credit from select carriers. What about accessories? Depends on the carrier. I'd like to stick with Samsung what's available, the Galaxy S7, which came out back in March. Galaxy S8 is expected in February or March. But it's unlikely that they'll try to push it out earlier or fill the gap because, well, when you've just had a big monstrous failure with a cell phone launch, you probably don't want to rush the next one.
True.
Could other phones catch on fire? There hasn't been much report of that. But let's answer the actual sword fight question that we're going to answer right now, which is, what should you do right now? What should you do with your Galaxy Note 7? So here is the straw poll. You guys can vote. I'll post this in chat so you guys can click on the little linky there.
Do it.
And give us your votes as well.
Do it!
This has now been posted in both chats. Yay! All right.
Woo.
So you can burn it, keep using it, but only charge it on airplanes. Take it apart to learn more about the dark magic that fuels its arcane power. Hydraulic press or sell it on eBay, listed as iPhone 7 Plus, barely used like new. What do you think, Kyle? What should people do?
I'm going to say that they should...
Sell it on eBay. Sell it on eBay. All right, Kyle's going for sell it on
listed
eBay.
Listed as iPhone 7, barely used, like new, because you know what? It's time that we eliminate them. It's time that we get rid of all the iPhone 7 users.
I see.
They are a cancer to this world.
So weaponize the Note 7.
Weaponize the Note. Well, it's already weaponized. That's the beauty of this idea.
Deliver it to a place where it will be more effectively used as a weapon against iPhone users.
Exactly. We're fighting fire with fire, essentially, quite literally. If we can eliminate all the people of the Earth who would buy an iPhone 7, then the world can be potentially a greater place. I mean, our economy would be booming. You know, human morale would just go through the roof. I mean, it would just help society in a variety of ways. We'd get rid of all of the Galaxy Note 7s that are defective, as well as all the iPhone 7 users. So, I mean, it's really a win-win. I don't see how this is a bad plan in any way.
Assuming they all result in fatalities.
Yes. I think at the rate things are going, Samsung has no effing clue what's going on with their own phones, at least the Galaxy Note 7. So we can assume that they are all fatally booby-trapped in some way or another, where eventually they will cause an amazing... great fatality to our enemy, who is the Apple iPhone user.
That's really drawing a line in the sand there. All right.
Yep.
I'm going to go with take it apart and learn more about the dark magic that fuels its arcane power, simply because, you know, I have to respect Kyle's response here. He's trying to take lemons and make it into lemonade. You're trying to make the best of a bad situation. And granted, using the Galaxy Note 7s as portable bombs to kill people, you know, this is very valid. It's very, very useful, very intelligent response. But, you know, I prefer to lean towards the more scientific approach, the approach that will help humanity as a whole a little bit better. And while the mass annihilation of many iPhone users simultaneously is tempting, and might possibly lead to a utopian society or something like that, I think taking it apart to learn about this, because obviously there's a dark power at the heart and soul of every Note 7 yearning to break free to cause destruction and chaos. And I think if we can study that, if we can harness that power, we should use the ring. You know, we should take it and make it our own and stand up against... You see where I'm going with this, right?
Nope, not at all.
Let's The hell did my mouse cursor go? All right, let's move on. Let's see what you guys think of this one. What should I do with my Galaxy Note 7? Results.
What do we
have? Hey, you win, Kyle. Sell it on eBay.
Well, I have the people's ear.
I mean,
Brilliant.
Honestly, that's a smart way to go. I obviously complimented you a couple times as I was doing my arguments, simply because, you know, it's you're looking for some quick profit and potentially, you know, some benefit to the world as a whole. Keep using it, but only charge it on airplanes. Came in second. Hydraulic press. I was in fourth place that time. And burn it, I mean, I put that on there because it's fun to say, especially with the Scottish accent. You
sure.
Know? Button it. You have to button it.
Button
it. Yeah, you got to put that little extra trill in there. But obviously, it'll do that by itself. No need for you to exert any extra effort there. All right, next question here. This is specifically targeted to Kyle. Have you played Gears of War 4 yet?
No.
Yes, I'm totally all about Gears. No, I've wanted to, but haven't had the time. Since Kyle answered first on the last one, I'm going to answer first on this one. And say,
do it, bitch!
No, I've wanted to, but just haven't had the time. Gears of War 4, kind of excited about it. I mean, a lot of you know, emphasis around it as a game developed by Microsoft, DirectX 12, sort of them trying to come back a little bit for the PC users. Try to prove themselves a little bit more. They can do a game developed for...
We can do PC. Yeah, we can do PC.
Developed for both a console and PC at the same time.
Kick PC in the balls.
But really, when it comes down to it, I tried to do a little bit in when they had the preview that was open this past week, the early access capabilities. But the very first day it was open, which I think was on the 5th.
Yeah.
We had some connectivity problems, unfortunately. I had a plan to do some live streaming and record the live streaming and do some kind of benchmarking at the same time, and basically just we couldn't. I mean, like at the time we started, like the servers were down when we were finally ready to go, and it just the whole thing kind of fell apart. So that was a bit of a failure on my part, I'll admit, but. Following up after that, I haven't really had the time to jump in. I've read some reviews on it and stuff. There seems mainly positive.
Yeah.
You know, anywhere from...
You checked the Metacritic.
Anywhere from 70 to 90% score, I think, is what I've seen. 70% being the more critical, the more cynical reviewers. 90% being the ones that are paid off by Microsoft, of course.
Yeah. It got an 84, which isn't bad.
84 on Metacritic.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, that's solid.
Pretty solid.
So, yeah.
All right. So am I supposed to argue against it now because you've argued for it?
No, you're supposed to now lie to everyone and say, yes, you've played lots of Gears of War.
Yes, actually, that wouldn't be a lie. I used to be an Xbox 360 owner. I played a lot of Gears of War 1, 2, and 3.
Gears of War 4.
I have not played Gears of War 4 yet.
No,
but
you have.
Yes, totally. Oh, no. Okay, it has to be about Gears of War 4.
Yeah.
It has to, cannot be anything outside of that box.
Yeah.
I see what you did there. Yes, I have played Gears of War 4 a lot. But you know what? I kind of have because it looks exactly like the previous three Gears of Wars. It's a cover shooter. You advance a little bit. You shoot some guys. You take cover. You shoot them some more. And then you advance some more. And then you take more cover and shoot some guys. It's kind of a wash and rinse and repeat sort of thing. But it's a fun series. I do enjoy the game. I've enjoyed 1, 2, and 3. I'm probably going to enjoy number 4 as well, especially now that it's on PC. I'll probably enjoy it even more, especially with higher refresh rates, higher frame rates, better graphics. It looks pretty damn good from the gameplay footage that I've seen. Just light years ahead of what I've experienced on the Xbox platform. So super excited to check it out, even though I have already played it.
Obviously, you've been playing it for
so
a while.
Much, so much.
That's all you've been doing the past few days.
Great game. Highly recommend.
All right. Well then, JD Gaming, thank you for your $5 donation.
JD.
You should have said, send them to Austin as an iPhone 7.
JD.
Also, try to get Wendell on the show.
Maybe.
We don't do very many, guests on the show, but definitely am down to work with Wendell. He's
one of us.
He's a very intelligent human being. Wouldn't be opposed to that at all. Alright, let's see what you guys have to say. How many of you have actually played Gears of War? Gears of War 4? Wow. See, we should know our audience.
Yeah. I could have guessed that.
Apparently most people are... Isn't it an Xbox game or something? This is kind of telling for me, though. I mean, to some degree.
Means, no, like, very few of our audience has actually gamed on an Xbox.
Has actually played it or gamed on an Xbox in general.
Yeah.
Or, I mean, is there a stigma around Gears of War 4 because it's been a console game? Not entirely. The original Gears of War was also available on PC. Or they,
yeah,
they
very
did,
recent.
Or they
though.
Did a remastered version.
Yeah. Not historically, though. That's, like, been super recent. I think it's just a lot of our audience is just diehard PC gamers. Where, like, if it's not a PS4 and not a, you know, an Xbox, then I probably played it. But if it is an exclusive to those consoles, I probably haven't. It's kind of like how there were certain PC games, PC exclusive titles, that when I was a console gamer back in my noob days, I had never even heard of or just had very little experience with.
Yep.
So.
All right. Well, guys, we're going to do a little bit of our last segment here. Which is Q&A. So if you have questions,
we might have answers.
We could make a vague attempt at answering them.
Yep.
You know what I was thinking a minute ago?
What?
I really want to go and get sushi.
Oh.
How good would that be?
Heather would kill me.
Damn it. No, but I don't. But we should.
It sounds like your wife's making something, too. It smells.
Is she making something?
I smell something good.
If she's making something, that's awesome, too.
Yeah. But yeah, oh,
I don't know though. But
so
yeah,
good,
that sushi option right after the show.
Those rolls,
they're really good.
The little Japanese mayo.
There's some good sushi place around here.
Yes, there is.
Oh, and I told you that place up the street is open still.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a really
it's
authentic,
like nicer,
like, you know, go in and sit down at a sushi bar type place.
We'll do it two shows from now.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll periscope over there and be like, look at this.
That'd be awesome.
Some sushi.
Now you get the Toro there.
Put your face on.
Why am I like a sandwich?
I
don't know. Something to do with white bread?
Because.
I don't know what that
means.
You've
got meat in the middle of your buns.
Barbecue rib. That's. You're probably right.
No.
Wait, where'd it go? Where's my knife?
Do you have
my knife?
No. Oh, it's here.
I took my knife. Barbecue Ribs asked, is that knife a Spyderco?
Yes, it is.
Spyderco knife.
Opinion on Toper switches for keyboards.
This is a dangerous
asked
knife.
Matt Chen.
I have sliced myself really bad with this part of the knife.
Ooh.
I closed it wrong.
Ooh.
Yeah. But this, Early. I really like this knife.
I like Toper switches. They're a little bit, they have a bit too much resistance for my liking. Their actuation force is a bit high, but I've gotten used to them. Like I've used one of the TKL Toper Switch keyboards from Cooler Master for quite some time, and I got used to that eventually. But it's really easy for me to like lose touch with it. If I don't use it for a week or so, then I get unfamiliarized really quickly with how much force is required to tap them. I know some people who really swear by them, but. For me, it's kind of a, you know, hit or miss.
The classic, like, standard Toper switches, the keyboards are fairly expensive. They're often pitched as keyboards for typers, not gamers, which I kind of understand. I did use a Toper keyboard for quite a while, and I can see how they'd be useful for typists. They have a nice, like, resistance to them, I feel like, and they're not quite as, mechanical switches... You know, they might have that tactile bump or whatever. But yeah, I like Toper switches, but they might not be for everyone. It really is the type of thing I feel like you need to go somewhere and, like, try each one out and mess around with a little bit. Jominator, thank you for your $5 donation. Sushi does sound good. Are we drinking? Yes, we are drinking. We have been.
We always are.
Trying to finish this oatmeal stout right now.
Let's see. Is the Corsair K70 a good keyboard? Yes, it is.
Yep.
It's not the only good keyboard, but it is a good one. It's one of the good ones.
It's a solid choice.
I use the K70.
Okay. Here is from our donations that Cell has been gathering, so I don't know when this came in, but Cyan505, thanks for your $5 donation. Love the show. Thank you very much. So much that I'm missing the season finale of Halt and Catch Fire to watch right now.
Good. Those shows are
yeah,
stupid.
I've never heard of that show before. I want you to know that you guys... I wanted to know what you guys thought about the future of Linux gaming. Do you see it expanding as Microsoft continues to fuck up Windows 10? Or will Linux never make ground in the desktop gaming community? I see Linux gaming as having made some significant strides recently, but still being pretty far off of, like, overtaking or even presenting a significant challenge to Windows gaming. I think the actions of Microsoft in the next year or so, as people transition over to Windows 10 and they continue doing these... I can't even remember the games for Windows. It's not games for Windows Live.
UWP?
UWP, yeah. The Universal Windows Platform games. I feel like how those play out will have a really significant impact on the gaming community. And I hope Microsoft respects and understands that the PC gaming community is a very tight-knit community that does a lot of communication with itself. So if they try to pull off some BS, they're going to get called out on it very quickly. And if that happens, like, every time Microsoft does something to screw up, there's more people who are like, you know what, I'm just going to go play on Linux. So the fact that Steam now has the Steam OS that's available as a Linux-based platform, and that there's more and more games available there, makes it more and more viable. But again, like I said, it's still niche, and it still has a long way to go before it's a...
Was it Tim Sweeney from Epic Games who was saying, like, Microsoft was planning to sabotage Steam in the future? To make their UWP games more appealing than Steam.
Yes.
So if something like that could potentially sway...
Yeah, but that stuff happening, like, there's really smart people like Tim Sweeney and there's other people who are going to... They're going to point that out really quickly.
Yeah.
And we're going to talk about it, guaranteed, on the show. And other people who do live shows are going to talk about it. And hopefully they're going to get such amazing pushback from the community immediately that they don't try to pull that nonsense. Because honestly, I'd like to see... both platforms available and viable, right?
More the better.
Yeah, I mean, having a competition from one side and the other. Yeah. But I mean, having Microsoft, Microsoft could do it, right? They could.
Yeah.
It's possible. And, like, that'd be cool. So, yeah, anyway. Thanks for the question, though.
I think we should probably close out, because I do have to go soon.
We do have...
We do have some Johnsons to show.
Are these... Did we already do these?
Go ahead and sound those off.
I think we already read
these.
Yeah,
we did those. Right. We did that. And we did that.
All right. So, yeah, we got Jominator, we got Cyan, we got O'Neill Geddes, and
fuck?
We got Jominator again. I think we already did that one, so yeah, sorry
okay.
about that. Okay, so thanks to all you guys for watching the show. Thanks to everyone who has stopped by and watched us live. We really appreciate it.
Yep.
And, yeah, if you didn't watch the first half, it's available over on Cal's channel. If you have watched both halves, then there's a playlist, and you can watch all the old episodes where we talk about more and more or less relevant stuff the further you go back. It's good times.
Some funny moments in there.
Yeah, I mean, occasionally we make a joke.
Some things are timeless.
Totally worth watching.
But we do have some Johnson shoutouts for those of you who happen to
pick
up some merchandise from our stores.
Thank you
very much.
Oh, my goodness.
First off, to Lee. Lee!
Dude, people are going crazy. You guys are freaking awesome.
Yeah, you guys are nuts. Thank you for picking up a BIOS flasher shirt in maroon as well as a CPU cooler shirt in navy blue. You'll be very happy with both of those, I'm sure. We have also got Shantanu. Actually, Shantanu, I think, was one of the guys who donated earlier. Thank
Shantanu
you very much.
Gets a double
Johnson.
Absolutely.
Thank you for picking up a Stay Positive shirt,
from New
as
York,
well as a couple
as
things
as well as
from
a
your
pub
store.
Glass, as well as a mug, as well as a thumbscrew shirt.
Nice.
You're going to get a shipping discount when everything ships all together, and thank you so much for your order and your support. That's freaking awesome.
Shout out to Kenneth Johnson to you, brother, for picking up a BIOS flasher shirt in maroon as well.
Where did it go? Never mind.
And we've got Kushal. Kushal, thank you for picking up a CPU cooler shirt in Heather Navy. Excellent. Excellent choice, my friend.
Nice. Kenneth gets a double Johnson, by the way.
Yes, nice,
Kenneth. Also picked up a thumbscrew shirt. Thank you so much for that. Kushal also gets a double Johnson as well.
Double Johnson!
Got the thumbscrew shirt. The tri-blend, of course.
Double Johnson.
We already said Kenneth. Wait, I have one or two more. Thomas... Also, a Johnson to you. Got a Zero Insertion Force shirt. He is from from the UK. Thank you, Thomas.
Nice.
Yes. Thank you so much. Rich gets a Johnson from Maryland. He got an English pub glass. Hope you enjoy that. It's It's great for drinking stuff out of. Carl from Texas also gets a Johnson.
Carl.
And Carl. I believe that's everything.
Carl.
All right.
Nice.
Wow. Huge support for you guys. Woo! From you guys this week on the store. So really, really appreciate you guys, all the orders and everything.
Yes, we do.
Wonderful.
Wonderful but stuff. That's going to do it for now, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. We will be doing an after party probably later tonight.
Yes, indeed.
I think we're going to be playing some H1Z1. I'm feeling some H1.
Which yeah.
You still have to get on the bandwagon.
I got it figured out. Steve helped me with it.
He helped you with the training process.
I wasn't ready for it last week,
yeah.
And it wasn't installing right. And
right.
And then I got really tired, and I copped out. So sorry about that, guys. Last
it might
week,
be all good now.
It's set up this week, so
Wifey
I'll be
Sauce,
there.
My wife Heather might actually be playing with us as well, and
nice.
It's only her second time playing, so you and her can probably learn together. I'm sure Steve's probably down tonight as well as I am, of course, so we can help you guys through it. It's cool because you can do duos, which is like, you know, a two-man group, a
no.
two-man team, or you can do fives, which is like five people on a team.
Okay.
So maybe like you, me, Steve, my wife, and his wife, and then we'll find like a fifth, maybe Cell or Spider or whoever else wants to join. Five of us can be
as long
on
as
a
I'm
team.
On Discord and I can say, what am I supposed to be doing right now?
That
That's,
is,
I mean,
paramount concern, and we will definitely handle that shortly enough. But so stay tuned for that on each of our respective Twitch channels, BitwitKY, as well as Paul's Hardware. We will be back with all that good stuff. So have a good night, guys.
Thanks for watching, everyone.
Love you.
Hit the like button.